Have you ever heard people saying, "What I see in you is a reflection of me," or "As within, so without"? This concept is called self-projection, and it is very, very real. This is one of the hardest things to take in, and this is why a lot of people won't accept it in the reality, because it's basically saying you are responsible for everything in your outside world. I want you to remember these things. Number one, being responsible does not mean you are to blame. Number two, taking responsibility is very empowering. Accepting this concept is basically saying you have the ability to control your life. Number three is the most important. So we only start self-projecting after the age of 7, give or take, because before that, our brains are recording. We're just taking everything in. Our eyes are the lens, our brains are the recorder, and everything we're just absorbing. As young children, our brain waves are only in delta and theta, so basically you're always in an imaginary kind of trance-like state. As you get older, we get a little more alert brain waves, which are beta brain waves. You have low beta, which is alert, mid beta, a little more alert, like when you're about to take a test, and then high beta, which is usually when you're angry in fight or flight. Beta brain waves are where we start projecting. So picture your mind right now on beta, like a projector. Everything that's in here is projected now onto your outside world. So projection is always how you treat yourself and not how you treat others. So don't expect to treat them nice and they treat you nice back. It's how do you treat yourself? That's how the world will treat you. The same thing applies to seeing. How you see the world and how you see others is exactly how you see yourself. I know this part is tricky because a lot of people have a hard time and say, wait a minute, if I see narcissists and racists and sexists, does that mean I'm racist and sexist? No, you have to go deeper. What is a racist to you? Is it somebody that's a bully? Is it someone that spreads hate and causes division? So take the label of what you see in the world and then dig deep as you can. And then everything that you wrote down, ask yourself, are you bullying yourself? Are you divided in yourself and are you mean to yourself? Finally, I need to address this because a lot of people ask me, wait a minute, I've been abused verbally, physically, and other ways. Did I project that? No, you didn't. And it's not your fault. Unfortunately, everybody in the world projects and we can get stuck in other people's projections. So if they've lived severe trauma, they will project that trauma onto you. But imagine a world where we can own all our projections. I feel like that would be the beginning to peace on earth.